Hi, in this video we're looking at calculating log2 from a log10 base. This is because on your calculator you typically have your default button for log, assuming that you want a log10 calculation, a log10 transformation, but you may not want a log10 transformation. Even in Excel, the standard formula is like assuming you want a log10. So in those instances, how do you actually get a log2 transformation? So let's take a look at how you would do it on your calculator or in Excel. The process is very simple. You simply have to divide your log10 value for the number that you are looking at by the log 10 to 2 value. So this example, if we want to get a log2 value for 8, what we do is initially put in the log button on the calculator and we put 8, and we know that it's giving us the log10 value, but we want the log2 value. So all we do is go back to the log icon, the log button on our calculator, or even in Excel, the log function, and then we put 2. And so now we've obtained the log value for 2, and we divide the log10 value for 8 by the log10 value for 2. And now our answer is actually the log to the base 2 of that value. And in this example, we're looking at 8. So log10 8 divide by log10 2, and we see that the answer is 3. Let's take a look. Let's do a few more just to deepen the impression. Now, in this example, we're going to look at not a log2 value, but what if we want a log3? So we can go ahead and put in the log10 value for 8 as usual, because the button just defaults to 10. And then we go ahead and hit that log10 button again. And this time we put 3, because that's the base that we now want everything to want the answer in. And so if we divide the log10 to the 8 value by the log10 to the 3 value, we now have our answer in a log3 basis, and so it's a 1.89 value that we now obtain. Let's just do one more as well. Coming back to a log2 base, which tends to be quite popular in some log fold change transformations, you would go ahead and hit your log10 value and put, if the value we want to obtain the log2 value for is 56.25, we go log button, which is a log10 56.25. We're now going to divide it by log10 to 2, because we want the base to be 2. And so we get an answer of 5.81. I hope you've caught the drift now. I cannot end this video without talking about log transformations. Why do we use this log? I hate when people don't tell me why things are the case, so I won't do that to you. So why do we use log transformations? So using log transformations allows you to show proportional rather than additive changes. It's also really convenient for visualizing upregulated genes as positive values and downregulated genes as negative values. I have a video on here which looked at even like the history of logarithms, because I find that if I'm just introduced to things like logs, which are not everyday use, without some sort of story meat around it, it doesn't really sit in my brain. It doesn't make sense. So I have a history video here. But in that video, you also see some example as to the scenarios where you use log, why you use log. And so log in particular is great for getting a positive value when you have an upregulation, and getting a negative value when you have downregulation. In particular, why would you choose a log2 transformation over the default log10, which is really been what this video has been about, that you're calculator button or Excel formula, we just assume it's a log10, but why would you want a log2 instead? Well, an example is, you know, if you have a doubling event or a reduction of 50% event, this is often considered biologically relevant. If you use a log 2 scale, this translates to a plus 1 or minus 1 unit increase or decrease. Whereas on a log 10 scale, this translates to a change of just 0.3. It doesn't look as dramatic. And so you may want to use a log 2 because it's a whole unit and it just gives better scaling when your changes are a bit modest or smaller. So this has been a video on how to use a log 2 transformation from the default log 10 that you get with your calculator or formula that you'll be entering in. I hope it was helpful. Thank you for watching. Thank you for liking. And thank you for subscribing. And hey, to all the subscribers, welcome. All the best with your data analysis and your experiments. Bye. God bless.